Today we're going to look at the Acti9 ISOBAR P distribution boards from Schneider Electric.
Plug on neutral, Gordon.
Well, Acti9 range from Schneider is something you're going to be seeing quite a bit of on the channel over the next coming years, because the board behind us is one we've specified for the rewire of our own industrial unit.
And if we've picked it, it must have features that save electricians time. And you know how we love that at eFIXX. So with that in mind, pick one, save me some time, Gordon.
Okay, well, we'll start with the P. Okay. And that's you've mentioned in the introduction, and that's the plug-on neutral.
Okay, so the plug-on neutral. So where does that come into, and how will it save us some time?
Okay, well, obviously now, a lot of circuits now have to have RCD protection.
They do, yeah.
And that's going to only increase over time as amendments change and new regulations come in. And if we look at a traditional RCBO,
okay, let's have a little look. Yeah,
we're used to seeing this neutral flying lead.
Okay, and we've also got a functional earth, I see there as well, so there's two connections.
Yeah, so obviously that takes up time, it also takes up space in the distribution board.
Okay.
And here's our one from Schneider Electric, Gary.
I see one glaring mistake there, we seem to be missing the neutral connection, which it needs.
Unless I flip it over, and there we can see, there's our neutral connection. And there's our functional earth connection.
And where do they go in the distribution boards themselves then, Gordon? So bring that one across.
Flip behind us. So this is the Acti9 board. Loads of great safety features in there. If you haven't seen the ISOBAR function, here it is. And we'll demonstrate that a little bit further as we go on. It's been around for some time, but here's the new plug-on neutral function here.
Okay, so the neutral goes in there. Is the other one for the functional earth?
That's it, yeah. Simply just clips in there.
So let's see one of those being fitted then. Fit a single phase RCBO. Got to make sure this tab is pushed in on the side and the breaker is in the off position, Gordon, before fitting it.
Yeah, so again, the key here is to make sure it's underneath the ISOBAR tab, otherwise yeah. You've got no chance of being able to slide over when you connect it.
That's it, fitted.
That's it, yeah. That was quick.
Super simple, let's fit another couple. So exactly the same as process, yeah. See how easy it is. Under the tab, click, done. And again, you're going to ask me in a minute, I'm sure, to take one of these out, aren't you, Gordon?
So how do you take one out, yeah?
We've got to just pull the yellow tab back out. So just pull that out into there, and then just pull it forward. Just got to make sure that, obviously, your ISOBAR tab is pulled back as well, and just simply lever it forward, and it's out. Again, to repeat the process, just push the tab back in. Make sure you're under the tab and in. Wow. Yeah, that says it all, doesn't it? That was simple, wasn't it?
And that can claim to save installation time by up to 50%, actually. So that's
right. We like that.
Yeah.
Mm. Now, the keen-eyed amongst you may have noticed a lot more going on this side of the board, including some blue tabs now, which I'm suggesting is probably a neutral connection then, Gordon.
It is. So that's the distributed neutral.
Okay.
That's something else you can add to this board, which is only possible because of the ISOBAR function.
Okay. So shall we see how we're going to fit one of those to get a distributed neutral?
Yeah, let's have a look.
So I'm going to remove these two screws in order to get access to the neutral. So pop the two screws out and then the plate will just pull forward. So there's one keep it in your hand and the second one, Gordon, and I'm just going to pull firmly on this plate and take it out of the way. Okay, I think the next one I'll remove, I didn't really need to do, did I?
No, I don't. There's a subtle difference between the plug-on neutral board and the one without the plug-on neutral.
Gives me a little bit more room is what I'll say. So there's a top tip here for us, Gordon, isn't there?
Yeah, so on this version here with the plug-on neutral, remove this tab from the distributed neutral bus bar.
Okay, use an Allen key to do so, and then just pop that to one side. You don't need that section, you just need the bar itself. And it's important you get the bar around the right way, so it's just going to slide into position, but it's actually got a thread on that, it needs to be at the back, so you just rotate it around to the back.
Yeah, so that threaded insert's where you're going to use, put the screw through to attach to the neutral bar at the bottom of the unit there.
Yeah, and then just firmly push in all the sections, so you see I'm just pushing it on the way down, and once you've clicked into position, it'll just slide down and be able to be bolted into position onto the neutral.
Okay, so we're going to bring in that Allen head screwdriver and obviously set that to the required torque. And the good thing is the torque settings are at the left-hand side there.
On the board, yeah. So just pop that into position and torque that one up. And that's the neutral bar then fitted, Gordon. We can go about fitting the next stage.
Yeah, and obviously you'd repeat that for the other side as well.
Okay, there you go, torqued up.
So the next thing is to fit the outgoing neutral links.
Okay, nice and simple, yeah. So just slide it underneath, so pop it underneath in the appropriate position. I'm sure you're a little bit worried now because I've just gone over the brown line conductor, Gordon, but yeah. Why is it not a problem?
Okay, so the ISOBAR system prevents you obviously making that a dead short between the neutral bar and that brown line phase conductor there.
So I get that in, and again, to the required torque setting, you're quite right, because I can't slide the tab across, I can't actually energise the line to neutral connection that it looks like we've made in that section. Okay, do another one.
Yeah, so again, you decide where you're going to have your outgoing wires that require neutral and just fit these links in the correct locations on that distributed neutral bar.
It's very simple, really simple process to do so. Again, just talk it up to the required setting, and that one's in position as well, like so. Got handy little covers now. They're in sections, and the right-hand side, I learned that you go from the top to the bottom, and the left-hand side, you go from the bottom to the top, meaning that in the future, you can just access them and just pop off the sections you need. So I'll cover the neutral there. So I need to get back to that, Gordon. I just need to take one section off.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, so if you wanted to add another outgoing neutral connection or remove one because you've decided to reconfigure the board, you don't have to strip everything back down to the bus bar.
Yeah, and you see I'll just cover two over now. So if I need to get back to either of those or both of them, yeah, just one cover comes off and we've got access. So pop those on and ready for the next stage. There we go, last one in. So here we go, going to fit our breaker and RCD. We'll come back to this at some point. Really important tip now, Gordon, isn't it, for fitting it?
Yeah, so you're going to get them underneath the isobar tabs. If you don't get them underneath, you won't be able to slide the tabs across to liven up the breaker once it's fitted.
So slight angle going and pushed it back into position. That's it. So all it requires now is, again, returning the screws to required torque setting. Get those cranked up, and then we can slide across the fixings if we want to at that stage. But I think just get those tight first, and then we're ready to move to the next stage. We'll show you in the presentation how to put this together later. There we go. That one's in as well.
And then just slide the isobar tabs across, yeah. And then, yeah, that would liven them up.
Yep, simple process.
So then just repeat that. I'm going to put some blanks in, which is for future expansion.
And pop the blanks in, and now we've got something here, Gordon. We've got
So that's another four-pole RCBO that we've converted. Again, we're going to look at that in a little while.
Again, making sure you just get them under the tabs. Yeah, there, before we actually start screwing them down. And
here's a dual-pole MCB for some of the developments we're going to connect to this board later.
Okay, so that's double-pole. So yeah. We've got a neutral and one of the line conductors. Tabs go back in, and then just requires you to torque everything back up to the required setting next. So crank those up. Going to put that plate back that you quite rightly said I didn't need to remove, but it gave me loads more room, I would suggest. Pop that one back on. And next, the cover for connections that we exposed for the neutral. That goes back on. Return the two screws. Right. Believe it or not, there is actually a torque setting for these as well, Gordon.
There is one newton meter for these, Gary.
Okay, I've got to find the other screw I've just dropped as well, so I'll pop that one on. It'll be there somewhere. Oh, come on, Gaz. Yep, there it is. So pop that one back in place. And that cover's returned then.
Wow, so that just demonstrates how flexible this range of distribution boards are. And it doesn't stop there. You'll notice in there, we had a three-phase RCBO, which is quite a rare item.
Yeah, we did.
Now, obviously, you've got a choice these days. More and more sockets need RCD protection.
Yeah, the RCD itself could either be in the socket outlet,
or
it could be in the distribution board. And we chose, in this case, to put it in the distribution board. Let's see how easy it was to put that RCBO together.
So we're going to take our RCD module here and attach it to our four-pole breaker to create an RCBO function.
Okay, and it's important we get our mechanisms in the correct position. The RCD needs to be up and the breaker needs to be down in order that we can next open up the area here, Gordon, which allows us access to the keyway. This is the bit that means that both function together. So in other words, when the RCD trips, it will operate the mechanism within the MCB. There you can see the two that need to be lined up. Simply drop them onto each other. They marry together really nicely and you squeeze, so just bring them together. So click them, quite satisfying doing that. So that's the two sections together.
Obviously you've got to torque those connections up to the required torque. So you're making the electrical connection between the two modules. So obviously the power comes out of the MCB and then into the top of the RCD function.
Okay, so crank those up. Next bit's really clever after this, Gordon. Once you've got these tight, there's a nice touch on the neutral connection, isn't there?
Yeah, there is, yeah. So you'll see hiding underneath this black shroud. We'll see that in a moment. But obviously you're thinking that lead's a little bit long. It's going to need to be shortened down.
It does look a little bit long, doesn't it?
But underneath the shroud here is actually another ferruled connection waiting for you.
We know we like a ferrule at eFIXX, so just remove that oversheathing. Sometimes easier just to cut it. So what I did there, obviously snip it back. You'll see that ferrule then.
Yeah, so that is clever. That's a nice little design feature there that makes your life easier.
Trim it back. Again, we can just pop it into position and get the torque setting correctly for this one as well. So torque this one up, and the module's almost back together then. So nip that one in, until it clicks. And then we've got a couple of other things to do, Gordon.
Yeah, so there's another locking tab that we just click into place.
The yellow one here, yeah?
Yeah, push that into place.
Okay, firmly click that down.
And then just put the terminal caps over the top as well, just because obviously they're not going to be used in the actual end.
And we can see here now that when the RCD trips, you can see it breaks the MCB at the same time.
So that's another unique feature of that board. And what it allows, we've got your RCD module and the circuit breaker. It's easy to configure the configuration that you need without having to carry masses of different part numbers. And again, it's that flexibility when you know, if you're in an industrial environment, things are changing all the time. New machines come in, old machines go out. Yeah, that's what I like about this range.
Is there anything else that we can fit to this board in order to expand the range?
Okay, so obviously looking at the catalogue, yeah, I found some other useful options. We've got some input configurations we can have here, and we've got this output, this expansion module to go on the top, where we might be adding in some contactors and some other control functions as we develop the unit we're in here, Gary.
As always, we're interested in your comments. Are you fitting the Acti9 ISOBAR system from Schneider in your installations? Are you thinking about fitting it in the future? Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.